Hello, hi, it's me, back again. If y'all hear talking in the background, my husband and his friend are outside at a bonfire, and I'm over here doing reactions because that's what I like to do. Anyways, dude, I got this these lights up there, and it's an app. You gotta change them yourself. It's this app, but I can change them. Let's go, like, okay, we just did Ill Mind of Hopsin 4. Now we're on 6. I just want to say that was intense. That was crazy. I said that in the last video that he kind of reminds me of Tyler, the Creator, because he literally does. But I don't know if people get offended by that. But we're doing Ill Mind of Hopsin 6. No idea what this is about. Very excited. Couldn't wait anymore. It's 11:51 p.m. I want to say this. It was like 9:30. I'm sitting on my computer and I'm like, I don't know what to do. I'm fucking bored. And I'm like, I'm gonna do reaction videos. And so I did. And so I started. And it's currently 11:51. It's almost 12 a.m. Okay, anyways, let's go. Captions are on. Because the last one, it was kind of hard. I had to like look away to focus. So this one's gonna be good.
Fucking overload on meth. Paramedic saved your ass. You was close to ghosts. You never did know which road to go. It's like you rode the boat and sailed away and hoped to hit the Golden Coast. But you sank like the Titanic. The incident had left your life damaged. And that's when I panicked. You thought you had it locked, but you ain't on the right planet. If you're trying to live your life right, plan it. It's like your mind vanished. You don't even know that. I wish that we could go back, because it's so sad when I tell jokes and you don't laugh like you used to.
I want to say something that's actually very deep. So, I have a sister, love her to death. She's clean now, but she was addicted to heavy drugs. And I hope she doesn't hate me for putting this on there. But she went to rehab, she's good now. She's about to have a baby, I'm about to be an aunt. But it caused a lot of shit with the whole entire family. And like, but at the time, like, when someone's in that state of mind, like, they don't really think about everything that they think that they're doing is okay whenever they're on that high or whatever. And when really it's not, and everyone around you is kind of like taking the fucked up end of the stick or whatever. But I feel like this song is gonna get me kind of feeling some type of way. I see that he's talking about a friend of his and how they used to be good. I do want to back it up though, because I really want to pay attention now, because the first part of it, I kind of like, my mind went straight to my sister. But she's clean now. She's good. She good. I love her. Okay. So let's go back. If y'all, I'm going back. So y'all don't have to watch this if you don't want to, but I'm going back. Okay.
Overdose, a fucking overload on meth. Paramedic saved your ass. You was close to ghosts. You never did know which road to go. It's like you rode the boat and sailed away and hoped to hit the Golden Coast. But you sank like the Titanic. The incident had left your life damaged. And that's when I panicked. You thought you had it locked, but you ain't on the right planet. If you're trying to live your life right, plan it. It's like your mind vanished. You don't even know that. I wish that we could go back, because it's so sad when I tell jokes and you don't laugh like you used to. I really hate to stress it, but you strange to mess with. So I keep my distance, because you always got this blank expression. Are you confused and unaware of your surroundings? Emotions are gone and no one's found it. It's overwhelming. Your mama told you that drugs are bad, but you ain't listened to the fire burned your ass. Now you understand.
I'm pausing it there because, wow, this is a really good one. I should have stopped you when I had the chance to. At the same, and I haven't gotten further into the song, so I don't know what he's going to say, but you can, like, try your absolute best to, like, get someone out of that, but it's, unless they want to get out of it, it's not going to do shit. Like, and that's the hard part, is, like, everyone around them, that person that's, you know, like, on drugs and can't get out of it, we're all like, it's easy, like, come, like, I'll help you, I'll help you. But if you can try to help as much as you want, but it's not gonna, you're wasting your time. Because it's like a, literally like a demon in their head saying, like, no, like, you need me. Like, the drugs talking, like, you need me. And until they have hit rock bottom, until they are done, that's whenever you can start stepping in. But, like, there's no stopping. I mean, okay, like, I get, like, I should have stopped you. Maybe, like, he started with something else and he's like, I should have stopped you. At the same time, that dude's his own person and he can do his own thing and he thinks that he's, like, he's good until it's too late. And he's wrapped up in it. And it's way too late. And here he is. Whole life changed. Everyone. Yeah. Yeah. This is kind of. Oh, this shit. This is deep. This is deep. Backing it up. I should have stopped you when I had the chance to do so. But back then I felt like that was too bold. You started hanging with new folks and made the drug environment your new home. This world is too cold. Could I have prevented this? Who knows? Ah! I know I just paused it, but damn. It's all about hanging out with the wrong and the right crowd. Like, your whole life, depending on the people you surround yourself with, can go this way or it can go clear fucking that way. And it's so crazy because that's literally what happened to my sister. Like, the wrong people, man. That's so crazy. It's so true. It makes me scared to have kids, man. For real, I'm scared of kids. I'm gonna be that mom that's like up their ass. I don't want to be, but I'm gonna be. Okay. And made the drug environment your new home. This world is too cold. Could I have prevented this? Who knows? They convinced you that the shit was cool and hip to do. Saying it would lift your mood and make you feel invincible. So you started skipping school, hanging with these wicked dudes. On the way that when you got older, you played a bigger fool. And it's pitiful. Where the fuck they at now? In they made 20s. Outside of a crack house, back when you met him, I had doubts. They put you on the bad route. And when you needed their help to pick you up, they fucking backed out. They fucking got. I gotta back that up a little bit. Right? Hanging with these wicked dudes. On the way that when you got older, you played a bigger fool. And it's pitiful. Where the fuck they at now? In they mid 20s, passed out. Outside of a crack house, back when you met him, I had doubts. They put you on the bad route. And when you needed their help to pick you up, they fucking backed out. They fucking got you. I can't lie, but now your brain's fried. You don't even act like you the same guy. Your mama told you that drugs are bad, but you ain't listen to the fire burn your ass. Now you understand. Like you always love, like you don't love me. And I'm mad at the world, cause that took away my homie. You ain't listen to the fire burn your ass. Now you understand. Like you always love, like you don't love me. And I'm mad at the world, cause that took away my homie. God, wait, they're little kids. Those are little kids. Like, this shows that, like, oh my God. They were, like, friends since they were, like, fucking 11 years old. Hanging out. And it's like, you know somebody whenever they're good. And then that devil, which is the drug, like, changes that person 100%. This is sad, man. That's so true, though. So true. You think you know somebody, and then something, you know. I call it the devil because it is. It's the devil. It's like the devil is in your brain. Those drugs are the devil, man. They'll fuck you up. Fuck up your whole life. But that's how the devil works. It's like whenever you're high, you feel great, right? You feel good. Ugh. Gone in the future. Oh my God. not physically gone, but like gone. Like the dude is not his friend anymore. Like that's not the friend that I knew. Huh? What?
But I was wrong. I ain't never felt this shit before. It gets me sore. I reminisce on us playing Nintendo 64 and that Christmas in 90s.
Sorry. I gotta back up.
Shit before it gets me sore. I reminisce on us playing Nintendo 64 and that Christmas in 97 we got new crispy boards and we was doing ollies in my kitchen on the slippery floors. Shit changed and it happened quick, but I can't forget that you was the first homie I started rapping with. You could have had half of this back when I had established it, but now I have to say it feel bad. Look at what your actions did, man. You were so outgoing and so hysterical, and seeing you now is just unbearable. It's terrible. You should have made your choices wisely, fucking with poison ivy. Without your brain, please tell me what would your brain like be. It's a struggle to get your ass to listen. You really hurt me and the rest of your family with all your bad decisions. We all
they're loud. I want to cry. Like, I really want to cry. I'm not going to. But, it's true, man. That shit. Just like. It's crazy to think that, like. I'm not trying not to cry, but. Like, everyone that. Like, you see almost people, and, like, they're like. The people that are like tweaking out bad, right? They're like, don't even know where they are. They're so high off their ass. Have no idea like what they're doing. And you have to think like at one point in their life, like they were like a kid. Like they were like 10 years old riding their bike. So innocent. You never know like what happened in their life, like how their parents were, whatever. But I'm just saying like they were a baby once. An innocent baby. And they were like 7, then they were 12. And it makes you wonder like what happened in their life to where they like they just went off the freaking deep end. Like it's crazy. This sucks. This is really sad. It's really sad. Yeah.
Struggle to get your ass to listen. You really hurt me and the rest of your family with all your bad decisions. We always told you that drugs are bad, but you ain't listened to the fire burns your ass. Now you understand. Like you don't love me. And I'm mad at the world cause the meds took away my homie. Give me back my homie. Please come home. I just wanna chill on the neighborhood block like we used to. Where'd you go? Never would've thought my best friend be gone in the future. But I was wrong. Excuse me, do you need a ride? Looks like it's going downtown. Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah.
That makes you wonder, like, if his friend actually died from an overdose. Cause, like, gone in the future. In the beginning, it was more like, well, I don't know. Like, it can be both ways. Like, I never knew that my friend could be gone in the future. Like, mentally gone. Or do they actually physically die? Like, it's... Jeez. Oh, these are so good. These are so good. It's so true. Everything hit that. I've watched like 7, 5. I just did 4. That was 6. Like every single song that he like sings or raps or whatever, it's like real ass shit. And it's like that makes like the best music because you gotta go through things to like I have no other words. No other words. Anyways. That was crazy. I loved that one. That was actually really good. I'm gonna show my husband that. Probably tonight. No, probably not tonight. It's already 12, so maybe tomorrow. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. If you aren't already subscribed, please subscribe. There's so much more Hopsin reactions coming on this channel, either with just me or with my girl Bella, but she's not here right now. But eventually she'll be here once her puppy is of age. But make sure you like this video if you liked it. If you didn't like it, that doesn't matter to me. Could care less. But yeah, I will see y'all in the next video. Peace out.